IvyLearn allows us to set up notifications for a vast array of activities. It is helpful to think of the notifications as our opportunity to tell IvyLearn what we want IvyLearn to send us, where we want IvyLearn to send it, and how often we want it sent. One of the primary types of notifications that both instructors and students will want to set is for conversations. With the proper settings, we can have IvyLearn conversation notifications sent by email or text message. In IvyLearn, we use conversations for many of the communications that take place between instructors and students. Within IvyLearn, you can access conversations by clicking on the inbox icon in the IvyLearn navigation menu on the left side of the screen. Conversations is set up similar to an email account and holds communication for all classes and groups in one convenient location. To learn more about using conversations, please view the IvyLearn Conversations video. Setting up notifications is a two-part process. First, you need to input your non-IvyTech email address and your cell phone number in your IvyLearn account settings. Next, you need to tell IvyLearn which notifications to send and how often to send them. First, let's look at our account settings. To begin, click on the account icon in the IvyLearn navigation menu. It's the top icon on the left side of the screen. A pop-up menu will be displayed just to the right of the navigation menu. To edit our account settings, we'll click on the second link, which is labeled Settings. On the right side of the screen is a module titled Ways to Contact. The first section is email addresses, and by default, your IvyTech email address will already be populated here. To add additional email addresses, click on the email address link, type in your email address, and click on Register Email. IvyLearn will send a confirmation link to the email address you've entered, so you'll need to go into that email account and click on the link to confirm the registration of that email address. You won't receive notifications through that email account until the address has been registered. Email addresses can be added at any time, and email addresses can be removed by clicking on the trash can icon to the right of the email address. Below email addresses is other contacts. This section can include push notifications to mobile devices on which the Canvas mobile application is installed, SMS text messaging, as well as some limited registered services which may include Twitter, Google Drive, and a few other available services. For this demonstration, we're going to add a cell phone number. First, click on the contact method link, type in your cell phone number, and then select your cell phone carrier from the drop-down list. After selecting your carrier, the SMS email will automatically be populated. Then click Register SMS. A confirmation code will be sent to your phone in the form of a text message containing a confirmation code, which you'll type into the box here. As with the email addresses, you won't receive notifications via text message until this confirmation code has been entered. Now that we've set up our notification methods, we can set up our notification preferences. First, we'll click on the Notifications link, which is the first link in our profile navigation menu here on the left. Again, it's helpful to think of the notification preferences as our opportunity to tell IvyLearn what we want IvyLearn to send us, where we want IvyLearn to send it, and how often we want it sent. The first column on the left is Course Activities. This is what we want IvyLearn to send. Mouse over any of the items listed and a pop-up will display describing what that activity is. For example, if we mouse over due date, it shows that this notification will tell us about assignment due date changes. There are multiple sections here. The first three are the ones we'll use most frequently. They are course activities, discussions, and conversations. The rest of the columns on this page are where we'll specify where we want notifications to be sent. The number of columns here will depend on the ways to contact that we added in the settings area. If you add no additional ways to contact, you'll only see your IvyTech email listed here. The symbols that appear in the column for each type of notification specify how often you want the notifications to be sent. The key for these symbols is at the top of the screen. The check mark means notify me right away. The clock icon means send a daily summary. The calendar sends you a weekly summary. And the X means I don't want to receive any notifications at all. Let's say I want to receive an email in my Ivy Tech inbox every time an instructor changes a due date. I want that notification to be sent to me immediately. We'll go to the due date row, and in the Ivy Tech email address column, which will be the first column, we'll click on the check mark. Note that changes made here are immediately effective. We don't need to save or submit our changes on this page. I like to keep track of my grades in all of my classes, so I want a daily summary of everything that has been graded sent to my Ivy Tech email inbox. So we'll go to the grading row and click on the clock icon in the Ivy Tech email address column to receive that daily summary. Next, I want a weekly summary of all announcements emailed to my Gmail account. We'll go to the announcement row, and we'll go over to the column for our Gmail account, and we'll click the calendar icon to receive the weekly notifications. The last thing I want to set up is a text notification whenever I get a message to my conversation inbox. We'll scroll down to the row labeled conversation message. For cell phone numbers, you'll notice we have only two options for notifications. We can set them to notify immediately or not notify at all. If we add a Twitter account or download the mobile app and set up push notifications, we will only have those two options for those types of notifications as well. Click on the check mark under cell phone number to receive immediate notifications. Finally, I don't want anything else sent to me outside of IvyLearn, so we'll go down the list and make sure that the X is checked on all of the other options so we're not receiving any additional communications.